The second episode of Shogun can be seen next Saturday at the same time, 9:15.
On Monday at 9:25, the Black and White Media Show looks at the image television presents of black people to a mainly white audience, and using familiar examples, considers whether it does more to counter or reinforce racial prejudice.
It's remarkable how the British white is still perceived, mainly by the British white, as superior in the last analysis. And these representations constantly help to bolster that. It's the cumulative effect through one's life of watching television, reading books, going to the cinema, listening to the radio. And those stereotypes are constructed socially. We learn them, and they can be unlearned.
Just because the character is black, there doesn't have to be any big stigma attached to it. You know, like in EastEnders the other night, they had the young black guy talking to a young girl and saying, you know, well, do you want to go out with me? And she's saying, well, I might not. You know, it's going, well, why not? You know, and it was nice, you know, because it could have been anybody. And I like that. I like that a lot. More of that, please.
The Black and White Media Show on Monday at 9:25 on BBC One.
There are highlights of today's play in the fourth test on BBC Two now, while here on BBC One we're entertained by Joan Armatrading.
Girl Joan Armatrading, she drinks hot water and she collects comics. Really? I mean, suitcases full of the Beano, which she takes on the road with her. And Joan is always on the move, always on the road travelling. And the thing is that she says this actually helps her find inspiration for her songs, observing people at airports and wherever she happens to go. Well, I have no doubt that Joan's next tour will take in deep space, but her most recent tour, which was a world one lasting 7 months, sold out everywhere, took her at this moment to Sydney, Australia. Good night. Ruth Maddock's choice of music is featured tomorrow evening at 6:40 when Cliff Michelmore talks to her at home on Sunday. That's followed by the first British television showing of Rehearsal for Murder, the feature film starring Robert Preston as a Broadway playwright who uses a seemingly innocent reading of a new play to find his fiancée's murderer. The cast also includes Lynn Redgrave and Patrick McNee. After the news, the mood changes to comedy at 9:10 for Night of the Campaign, which is a look at the lighter side of life for political party workers in West Belfast. At 10:15, Jane Glover sets the scene for this year's promenade concerts, which are to be shown in Omnibus, and then at 9:25, Choices examines the ever-present, but now particularly topical question, of the imbalance between the world's rich nations and individuals and the world's starving millions. At 11:00, Anthony Burton presents the third part of the story of the cotton industry, and at 11:30, Fred Housecoe looks at another slice of history, that which is on the doorsteps of Halifax. That's tomorrow night, here on BBC One. And the weather. Many places will start dry and bright tomorrow, but wet and windy weather will reach Northern Ireland, Wales and Western England by midday, and will spread quickly to all but Northern Scotland during the afternoon. Some of the rain will be heavy, and it'll become very windy with severe southwesterly gales in the Irish Sea and English Channel. Well, now we've just about reached the end of another Saturday night on BBC One, but in fact it's now Sunday morning, the 4th of August, and the 85th birthday of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. Our congratulations and very best wishes, ma'am, for a very happy birthday. Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, 85 today. And this evening, Sunday evening, at 7:30 on Radio 4, there'll be a royal radio entertainment with items and artists of Her Majesty's choice, interspersed with some surprise birthday greetings. That's on Radio 4 at 7:30. Well, now the time is approaching 9 minutes past midnight, and it's time for BBC One to close down. So this is Malcolm Einan wishing you a very good night, with our thanks for your company.